am not letting it go where it needs to go. It is a holding attitude. Keep it for myself, not letting it go to anybody else. If somebody comes to your house and asks for milk, you have it in your fridge. But you know that tomorrow I want tea and I need that milk for my tea. But that person wants it now.
Charity begins at home.
Yes, surely. And Aparigraha is on that subtle level, it has to be understood, the subtlety of it. So if somebody comes and asks, yes, I have it, okay, just take it. Kal ke chai ka kal dekha jayega. It's okay. Because you know that Dudwala is going to come, I'm going to get the milk tomorrow, but maybe at night if I study and I want tea, and then I should have milk in the house, okay? So that is hoarding. Somebody has come to your house and you have to provide tea. You don't give tea to that person just because you want it afterwards. Or maybe your husband wanted, maybe your children wanted, whatever the reason may be. But you don't give it for some special cause. Then it is a hoarding attitude. These attitudes are very, at the physical level, it can be understood. And all people here who have gathered in this PLRC too, I don't think on the physical level we do abide by these yamas. But we have to see that through speech, through mind also we have to abide by these yamas. And it is very interesting when we start doing it. Okay? Now we'll just close our eyes. Any recent incident we'll go through. We are going to first test a very, it can be an intense incident, a happy, sad incident, any incident, you, whichever comes to you. Just take deep, long breaths and start reliving that incident. And now you have to assess that incident. How much truth it has in it? Was I really true to myself? At that time, what was my mindset? What were my emotions? And maybe you can just reverse that, rewind that full incident right from the time it has started till it ended. What was the thought process which went on inside my mind? Ahimsa, Satya, Asteyam. Test it with these yamas. How much you can draw a scale from 1 to 10 and rate yourself for that particular incident. Yes, Satya, maybe I am getting 5 points. Just wait from 1 to 10. And now go through the effect of whatever has happened. What were your actions and what was the effect of that action? Does the effect tally with the action? Does the effect harmonize with the action? Or it is refracting. Now get connected to a similar incident, maybe some few years back, from what has happened now. A similar incident. in this lifetime, of course. Just go for whatever pops up through intuition. And now compare these two incidents. Have I really grown up over years? Has evolution really happened in my mind and speech? In my emotions? Remember Satya, Ahimsa, Asteya, not stealing, Brahmacharya, body, mind and speech, both, all three. Now, just take a deep long breath and now you can open your eyes. This is how we are going to test ourselves daily. We are going to do it for the niyamas also. Let us see what the niyamas are. Yeah. One more thing, a collective effect of yamas. Individual effects were given in that chart. Collective effect of following the yamas is we tend to become more and more cheerful throughout the day. Anger and all starts subsiding. Shatvikaras, the Shatvikar, Kama, Krodha, Madha, Matsara, Dambha, Ahankara, they start subsiding. Compassion grows. And unconditional love starts happening, what is called as Maitri, Karuna, Mudita. This starts happening. Patanjali has told about these effects also. Non-attachment, a detached attitude towards people, towards things, towards emotions, towards everything. Non-attached attitude starts happening automatically. We don't develop it intentionally, it starts following as an effect. And of course, wisdom starts growing. Wisdom means not knowledge, of course we know that. Yamas have to be followed all together. Satya follow kiya, Brahmacharya nahi follow kiya, toh nahi chalega. It have to be followed all together. Yes. And they are serially ordered. Ahimsa, Satya, Asteya. Okay. So, I have told you this already. Speaking Satya, we have to be Ahimsak also along with Satya. Similarly, Brahmacharya, Asteya, Satya, Ahimsak. So, it will be that way, all five together. Should be followed by mind, speech and body, thoughts, expression, as well as physical actions with a priority to thoughts. We all know that what is going to go in the next life is the mind, okay? The causal body, it is the mind which is going to go there. So mind is on the priority, always. So physical actions are less important than the mental actions. So thinking mentally, stealing mentally also, you have already stolen. Whether physically you have done it or not, in action you have done it or not, physical action. But you thought of doing it, yes, the stealing has already happened. So it will be noted in Chitragupta's diary. So
it and PLR
yeah, of course, through PLR and all we can undo all these things. That is the process of undoing it. But we have to be aware continuously. And the five niyamas, which we know all these. Okay, shaucha, cleanliness of the body and mind of course. And refinement of intellect, the internal refining process, as the thought process, the intellectual body has to be refined. Through knowledge also we can refine it, but only through knowledge it won't be refined that much as we once we start applying the knowledge in our life, that refinement will start happening. So Shaucha will include that refining also. Following in Marathi, there's a Santa Jnaneshwara said, Ekhadi Tari Ovi Anubhavavi. So at least one Ovi of his, you have to put it in action every day. At least one. Or at least one thought you have to start putting in action every day. So Santosha, contentment. So this contentment attitude has to be followed for the present. When we are living in the, our mind is in the future, we are planning something, of course we should not be contented. We should always feel, yes, I have to grow. And I'm not attained enough. Okay, so, but the attitude for the present, it's okay. I'll get that, but now I'm happy. So the happiness attitude, then it will happen like India, the growth process will stop. It will get stagnant. Because Indian people are very happy, all the economy is falling down and we are happy with that economy. So we should not be happy in that way. For the present, yes, it is wonderful situation because we are the happiest people in the world, I think. But for the future, our future will be at a loss. So it's Santosh should be for the present, not for the future. The effects are given. Shaucha, we gains non-attachment of body and physical contact with others. We don't feel like touching the other person. Means not that we refrain from touching, but now touching somebody else is not a necessity for me. Now I can be without the other person very happily. No need of somebody else sitting next to me and saying, "Haan, bahut achha kiya tune." There is no need of that now. You start becoming happy with your own self. Okay, so we should not take it negatively. Against cheerful mind, one-pointedness, mastery over senses and self-realization. Mastery over senses, initially it will start with the control of the senses. Through Shaucha, we start gaining control over the senses. Control is the first step and the next step will become the mastery. So Santosh, we gain unexcelled bliss, we become happy, happy, happy and happy. Yes, that's it. Tapa is the, in PLR we do the reliving process. It is equivalent to tapa we are doing. Actually burning out the Sanchita, removing our energy blocks. Okay, we can do it by meditation also, but here we do it through PLR. And internal impurities are destroyed, gains mastery over body and senses. Internal impurities are destroyed, the Sanchita becomes less and less, less and less. And of course, the Sanchita is pulling you towards the past. So the past influences, the strength of the past influences that becoming less and less, and we can move forward in the process of evolution very easily. Swadhyay, this is what we are doing, self-testing. Swadhyay means not just reading spiritual books. That is of course one part. Gaining knowledge is one part. But knowledge is not enough. Self-test and self-assessments have to be done daily in every action. Not once a day, throughout the 24 hours, it has been said that you have to do this self-assessment even during your sleep. Even when you are asleep, you have to continuously assess that, are you aware? When you are sleeping, your body is sleeping, but your mind will remain awake. So this assessment has to be done for 24/7. The more and more you gain this mastery, the more and more you will gain in the process of evolution. Communion with desired deity. What we do in PLR, we directly connect to masters, thanks to our guides who have done it for us. But surely, through Swadhyay, we start getting it on our own. All the saints have got these desired communions through meditations, through bhakti yoga. So they have been, it was a totally subjective way they have got it. In PLR we are doing it objectively also, because somebody else is helping us doing it. So but through bhakti and through dhyan, through meditation, we can really achieve it. And that happens with Swadhyay. Swadhyay means meditating every day is also a part of Swadhyay. Meditating means being aware. The more and more aware we become, more and more aware we become in every action we do. More and more awareness follows, we'll start getting these wonderful. Yes.
Ma'am,
what
is the difference between yoga nidra and meditation?
Between?
Yoga nidra and meditation.
Yoga nidra can be turned into meditation, but is every yoga nidra will not be a meditation, but every meditation can be a yoga nidra. Yoga nidra means we know shavasan, physical relaxation, that is what is shavasan is. Then you go in yoga nidra, you move one step forward in to the emotions and the mind level.
But you're totally aware of the surroundings, what's happening around.
But we move only up to the mind level. And in meditation, we move up to the intellect level and the anandamaya kosha. We move up to that level in meditation. But in the yoga nidra, we move only up to mind level. So every meditation has to be a yoga nidra, of course, because we are going through the mind. We are using the mind as a passage. So every meditation has to be a yoga nidra, but every yoga nidra may not be a meditation. You can convert it to meditation. Still go deeper and deeper and then convert it to meditation. It's okay.
But can we come back?
Yeah, of course. It is meditation, no? Yeah. Yoga nidra means not samadhi. Like jivan the time has to in sanjivan samadhi lete hai na? That is not yoga nidra. Again the same thing. That is a yoga nidra, but every yoga nidra may not be that.
Probably last 15 minutes, but I only got up after 45 to 50 minutes.
Yeah, in meditation, our physical sensations start getting relaxed, no? Totally, as if sometimes we feel that the body is not there at all. So we have surpassed the yoga nidra level and gone further.
No, my question is, why didn't the sankalpa work at that point when it was so strong?
We never know when we are going to get aligned. When we are going to go through the right path, we will get aligned. And we never know when we start whether this is going to be a right path or no. That is why we have to be continuously aware. Because at every point there will be some divisions. Every point there will be this or this, this or this, this or this. We have to be continuously aware and choose the exact right path. At any point of time, you may fall the other side. At any point of time, then that time the meditation won't be successful. You have done exactly the same things, but that time it was not a success because you lost an awareness for a certain moment. Yes, it has gone. Again, you have to start from the beginning. So it's okay. We trial and error is the method we do. Making errors is wonderful. We have to be happy that we are making errors, because that is the point showing that we are doing something. Only if we are going to do something, we will make errors. So, Adhyaya, Ishwar Pranidhan, we have to do it with full trust. Those Patanjali Rishi means, Ishwar Pranidhan means cosmic energy. Surrender to the cosmic energy. He is not talking about Ishwar as God. He is talking about Ishwar as the cosmic energy, the principle behind the energy. So, we have to trust. Go by the path of trust. What we are talking about today, left brain and right brain.
So, God and cosmic energy is not one and same.
No.
So, can you explain it once again?
There are many levels in the cosmic energy system, there are many lokas, there are many levels. And one of the levels, there are gods. Gods are also beings. But they means, if at all any god has to, there are many Indras, there are many Vishnus, there are many, many. Vishnu comes to the earth every time. So at one point of time on the earth, there will be many Vishnus. Because he has taken birth as in the physical form and he is helping people in that physical form. But gods do it. Cosmic energy, just the play is going on. It is just the tattva behind.
Then what is the formless we say?
Formless.
And cosmic energy.
Yes, saguna and nirguna. So the nirguna is the cosmic energy. Actually, it is beyond that. But for our understanding, we can say it is the nirguna path. Because we will not understand beyond, because we don't understand even nirgun. So maybe for us, Osho used to say, many people used to ask Osho, after attainment, what happens? He used to say, first attain, then I'll answer you the question, then the answers will come to you, don't worry. First attain, at least. So we have to go to that level to see the other side.
Ma'am, the astral travel of a dream, meditative state and yoga nidra, is it the same?
Astral travel of dream and yoga nidra.
In a dream.
In yoga nidra we do it, means we decide and do it, no? And in dreams it happens.
Yeah,
on
so,
its own.
So is it called?
We don't master it. In yoga nidra we master it.
And even in meditation.
Yeah, we give self guided yoga nidra we do, no? And that means we are guiding our own selves. That yes, I want to go to this such and such place, I want to see such and such deity, I want to do this and this, I want to create visual creations we do. In yoga nidra we can do that.
Can you jump on to a different level in that? I mean, can you just go out of one hemisphere?
Yeah, we can.
You can.
Maybe you are aware of it, maybe you are not aware of it. That is different, but you can.
But you can't get lost.
Means maybe you jump to some other level, but you are not aware that you have jumped there. That can happen. Initially this happens because we are not aware of that. Then we start searching, are ye mujhe kya ho gaya? What was this experience all about? Then we start searching in the books, in scriptures, then we come to Dr. Newton, we go to some people here, and then we start searching the answers for the experience we have got. How it has happened to me? From where it has come? This is not a normal experience for me. So, by fluke we get such experiences. But we are not aware that we have got such an experience. It was a spiritual experience, we are not aware at that time. Afterwards we come to know. So, Ishwar Pranidhan attains the transcendental or infinite levels of awareness. So, it is the, what as Osho has called, it is the last leap. Even for the last leap, you have to go by trust. Just trust and take the leap and surrender to the cosmic energy. Whatever happens will happen. And at this last step, people don't jump. Zen philosophy says, yes, you can attain here and now. Here and now. Api. You just think of it and it is possible. But we are not ready to leave everything. So we are not ready to detach from everything. What we think is, अरे ये गया और वो भी नहीं मिला तो इसमें अटक जाएंगे. अच्छा है ये है हमारे पास, पर we should keep it with us. So we don't take the leap. We don't really trust the cosmic energy. Actually we should. That is different, but we don't. We have to see to the fact, because otherwise we would have reached that samadhi levels and all that. But we are very afraid of taking that leap. And there is another way of what Bhagavad Gita has told, how to judge your own self by the three gunas, sattva, raja and tama. We use these words very often in our, as Indians, we do use these words very often in our daily life. You have to eat sattvic food. Aye, tamas mat khao. We use these words very, very often. But actually, we should know the deeper meanings of it. So, though the chart is from sattva, raja, tama, we'll do it the opposite way. Because once we are in a very sattvic thing, then we don't feel like going down to tama. So, we'll start with tama and go to sattva. So, what is tamas? Tamas is the inertia, it is the basic energy force. It is a passive energy, a characteristic of tamas is. And the rajas is motion, continuous activity. This Brahman is rajas in nature. It is continuous, the play is going on. And it will go on infinitely, so that is totally rajas in nature. Okay, so, and tamas is the inertia, the black hole. Is the tamas. So, it, don't think that tamas is bad and rajas is bad and only sattvic is good. It is not that way, but for our evolution, we have to be more sattvic. That is different. But we can't be, because if we are continuously in activity, how will we become steady? And how will we move forward? So, if we are in continuous activity, we may fall down. Okay, we will become tired. Yeah, because we have physical levels also. We are not just energy. Energy doesn't become tired. But physical self, the gross, becomes tired. And so, we have to move forward with the gross. So, that is why we say that sattva is better. So, sattva is light, intelligence and illumination, light, total light. And Patanjali Rishi has said that he has explained the whole world, this process of evolution and the whole world as Chitta Vritti Nirodha. Chitta Vritti, he has to call it as Vritti, vibrations. It is a whole world is full of vibrations. And we have to make the vibrations still, which is not possible. That means we have to be detached from the vibrations. The awareness has to be detached from the vibrations. Then that is Chitta Vritti Nirodha and that is the Samadhi, that is the yoga. We can attain. So the he has told that sattva is the least, it has the least frequency level. And it has the highest frequency level. On both the ends, sattva is there. It has the least infra and ultra frequencies. But it is frequency, it is vibration. So, we have to remember that ultimately we have to leave sattva also to move forward, to take the last leap. We have to move forward, but we have to go towards sattva because only through sattva we can take the jump. We can't take the jump through rajas and tamas. So, if we are moving forward in the process of evolution, we have to become more and more sattvic. And that is why sattva is given that much importance. That does not mean that rajas and tamas can be avoided. Role in the process of evolution? Tamas, no motion, no growth, no maintenance, just it is static. And rajas, tension, stress, twist, compression, continuous friction, no? This churning is going on and on and on and on and on and on. So there will be continuous stress, continuous friction, continuous twist, compression, this and that. All types of forces moving in opposite directions. So, it will tend to, if you are following the morals and ethics, you will enjoy. If you are not following the morals and ethics, you will fall down. But there will be no growth even if you follow the morals and ethics. Because that continuous churning is going on and it will not allow you to move forward. But what sattva will do? Sattva has become quite stable even in the infra level and even in the ultra level. Because the vibrations are so fast that if they are as good as you will not be able to understand the vibrations. So it is those are that fast vibrations. So the growth and maintenance will start happening, will start growing. Maintenance will also happen. Tamas, emotions and mind. Dominant part of chitta, Rajas, emotions, mind, ego. Rajas is full of ego. That is the trap. The last trap is also the ego trap. You may leave emotions, you may leave the mind, but ego and knowledge trap is the worst trap, which Patanjali has told that becomes the worst trap. You won't be able to leave it. And it is very subtle. It will take different forms. It will take the forms of sattva to show as if I am sattva. It will take the form of sattva. The ego is so subtle. Bahurupi, ego becomes bahurupi because it has knowledge with it. It has all possible knowledge. It will have lot of logic, and it will show you that yes, I am sattva. It will prove to you yes, I am sattva. But you have to be very careful at such places. Sattva, dominant chitta powers, intellect, wisdom. From the five koshas, the last two koshas, intellect and anandamaya kosha, are dominated by sattva. The speed and the direction of pull, tamas will always pull you down, and the speed is very slow. Rajas, the speed is always fast, side to side or any haphazard movement, okay? And the pull is always downward, means towards the life and death cycle.